Class of 2022, the BHS Counseling Team is excited that you're beginning your high school journey with us, and we want to help as much as we can. The purpose of this video and slideshow is to make sure that you are good to go for your course selections for next year and to review your graduation plan. In the next week or so, you're going to be selecting courses for next year, and we understand that it can be a little bit scary and a little intimidating. By going through this overview, we hope to ease your nerves about this next step as you begin your high school years. All right, so let's begin. We're going to start by going over the required courses that you need in order to get your BHS diploma. The outline that I'm going to go over is in your BHS course guide on page 6. And just to know, the BHS course guide is also online on the main BHS webpage under Quick Links 2018-2019 registration. All right, so let's have a look at that. If you look at this screen, what this does is that this outlines all of the requirements that you will need at Burnsville High School in order to get your diploma. These classes are non-negotiables, meaning that you can have a million credits, but if you don't have them from these specific areas, you still won't get your diploma from Burnsville High School. As you can see, we have it laid out under subject areas. And under each subject, students can choose regular classes, advanced placement classes, honors classes. That's totally up to you. At Burnsville High School, we're a two-semester school, meaning first part of the year is semester one, second part of the year is semester two. Most of our year-long courses are identified by A and B. A would represent semester one, B would represent semester two. If you pass a class for one semester, you will earn one full credit in that course. As well, Burnsville High School is on a seven-period day, each period lasting about 48 to 50 minutes long. All right, so let's go through the requirements. As you can see in language arts, you are required to have a full year of English in 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th grade, and 12th grade. In social studies for grade 9, you'll see that we have human geography for one credit. That does mean that this is a one semester course. Students who choose regular human geography will have an elective course semester 1 called Success 191, and then second semester they will have human geography. For those students who choose Advanced Placement Human Geography, that is a year-long class. So you will have AP Human Geography A, Semester 1, AP Human Geography B, Semester 2. But you will also have that elective Success 191 course, Semester 1, along with your classmates. In Grade 10, we require a full year of World History. Grade 11, a full year of American history, and then in 12th grade, you'll have one semester of economics and one semester of American government. In mathematics, we require, in 9th grade, a full year of geometry, in 10th grade, a full year of Algebra 2, and in 11th grade, a full year of functions and trigonometry. For science, we require a full year of physical science in grade 9, in grade 10, a full year of biology, grade 11, a full year of chemistry. For health and phy-ed, in grade 9, you are required to take a physical education course called ITF, and that stands for Individual Team Fitness. As you can see, it's for one credit. That does mean it's a one semester class. So you will have that class either semester 1 or semester 2, but you will not have it for the full year. In grade 10, the same follows for health. It is a one credit class, which means that you will have it either semester 1 or semester 2, but not for the full year of your 10th grade year. For fine arts, Burnsville High School requires two courses somewhere between 9th and 12th grade to fulfill this requirement. It does not have to be a year-long course. It doesn't have to be a sequential course. You don't even have to take two fine arts in the same year. But somewhere between 9th and 12th grade, you need to take two courses and pass them that are identified as meeting the fine arts requirement. And finally, electives. These can be taken all throughout your high school years here at the high school, 9th grade through 12th grade. If you are looking to have a four-year college option on your plate for after you graduate, electives might include world languages such as Spanish or French, additional fine arts classes, additional math classes or science classes. This is totally up to you for what your plans are after high school. As well, your elective selections should be following your pathways here at the high school. From what you've done on your Naviance account so far, is that you can align what you like and what you're interested in with our elective classes here at the high school that are designated under certain pathways. You can take courses from all different pathways, and these will all be a part of your elective choices. For a grand total minimum required of credits at the high school, it's 45 credits. So, like I said, we are on a 7-period day here at the high school with 2 semesters. When you select your courses at Burnsville High School for next year, you have 14 spots, and that's because we have a 7-period day and 2 semesters. So 7 plus 7 is 14. So if you're wondering how that works out in your selections, here's how we've kind of laid it out. English is for a full year. Then social studies is for 1 semester along with Success 191. Math is a full year. Science is a full year. The ITF class will be there first semester or second, but not both. And then the other spot would be open for you. And then for your next selections, you can either choose world language classes, maybe get your fine arts classes done. If you want to choose classes that are in your pathway, those are all great options for your last selections at the high school. But also know that if you want a study hall, all you have to do is just choose 12 spots. Leave 13 and 14 open, and you can choose 12. Then you would have a study hall each semester. If you only want to have 1 study hall, then you choose 13 classes. If you don't want to have any study halls, you choose 14 classes. So sometimes it gets overwhelming and students think, well, how can I possibly get all of these things done at the high school in the amount of time? So here we have a breakdown of each grade level. And in this breakdown, we've actually given only 6 academic classes per semester with 1 study hall. You can choose to have 7 classes, but you have to have at least 6. So if you see here, if you pass all of your classes in 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th grade, and 12th grade, you'll wind up with a grand total of 48 credits, and that is the average of our graduating senior. When you look at our previous slide of 45 credits, that's minimum. That means you just made it. Our average is 48 for those students who are planning to go on to any kind of education past high school. So as you can see, there's lots of room for you to be able to have a study hall, have your pathway classes, and still graduate on time with a little bit of breathing room. We often have questions from 8th graders wondering about, well, what happens if I don't pass a class? The learning curve from 8th grade to 9th grade in regards to doing homework is quite big. Many of our current 9th graders will tell you that you will be doing homework outside of school almost every single day. And that's pretty normal. And it's not because the classes are so hard at the high school, but as was stated at the beginning of the slideshow, is that at the high school, each class is only about 48 to 50 minutes long. And so there's not a lot of time to get work done in the classroom. Now, if you choose to have a study hall, it definitely gives you a nice cushion, but it will not take away the requirement that you will need to do work at home outside of school. If you are in a situation where you don't pass a class, the reality is this: you must make up that course. It doesn't matter if it's an elective or a core class, it still counts towards your 45 credits to graduation. If you find yourself in that situation, there are some things at the high school that we try to do in order to help you get to passing. One of those options is called unit recovery. If you fail a class, but you're in that 50 to 59% range, you would work directly with that teacher and identify 1 to 2 units that you didn't do so great on. They will set up programs on a computer for you to get those done within a timeline of 1 to 2 weeks. If you successfully complete that, your grade will change from an F to a D minus, and that's the highest grade that you can attain through unit recovery. It's not the best grade, but it definitely saves you from failing that class. If you're in a situation where you're not eligible for unit recovery, the class was just not going well for you at all and you weren't even close, there are 2 options that you can choose from to redo the entire course. 1 is online course recovery, and the other is summer school. Both of these options do not take away the original F from your transcript that you earned from failing the class, but The new grade for the makeup course will now also be on your transcript. So what is an online course recovery? Well, these are full courses. You can only take one class per session, and at Burnsville High School, we have two sessions. We have a fall and a spring session, and each session is about 10 weeks. You will be assigned an online teacher here at the high school. It's a for real live teacher at the high school. The very first day of your session, you will meet with your online teacher, and they will go through the program, make sure that you can log on, have your username and your password. But then from that time forward, your online teacher acts more of a tutor than an instructor. That's because all of your instruction will be given online through the software, either by tutorial or by video. All of your assignments, your quizzes, and your tests will be done online. Throughout your 10-week session, you are required to meet face-to-face with your online teacher between 8 and 10 times. And that's to check in to make sure that you're doing all right in the class and getting what you need to get done. But also know that your online teacher is available Monday through Thursday from 2:45 to 3:30 here at the high school if you need any extra help. Each class is approximately 40 to 60 hours worth of work time. That's option one, to regain a course that you failed. Option two is traditional summer school. This is actually going to a class and sitting in the class to receive the instruction. For each class, it's a 4 to 6 hour block for 2 weeks, and that's per class. During summer school, you can only take up to two courses. Now, because it's such a short time frame, attendance is crucial and is mandatory. Even one day missed could result in no credit for the entire course. So, knowing that those are your limited options for recovering courses if you don't pass them, your best plan is to pass the courses the first time around. And so one of the things you need to be aware of is really knowing where you're at in your classes. And if you find yourself falling behind, address the issue as soon as possible. Don't wait until you're at the F mark in your class. If you're getting to about a C-D, that's when you should be immediately talking with your teacher, calling them, emailing them, coming in before school, meeting with them after school to be able to get back on track to pass that course. Please do not wait until the last couple of weeks before the end of the semester. At the high school, that is not enough time to be able to recover a failing grade. With all of this, if you're having a hard time with the class, if you're not able to work things out with your teacher or need a strategy to do so, please talk with your counselor so that we can help you. At Burnsville High School, we do not have teacher preference, meaning that students cannot pick and choose what teachers they have. So your counselors are a big asset for you to be able to work out a strategy on how to get through when you're not doing well in a class. Last thing is, please complete your course planner. Anxiety and nervousness comes from not knowing what your plans are. That Naviance course planner will help you plan through your next 4 years here at the high school. It doesn't lock you in, but it gives you a nice rough draft to be able to plan so that you're not caught off guard with any of the requirements or timelines that you may have. So please refer back to your course planner to review your choices of courses when you select them in the next couple weeks. Make sure that they're in line with the graduation requirements, number of credits, and the courses that you need for each year, and that they fall in line with your pathways with what you're interested in. Once again, we are very excited to have you at the high school. We are looking forward to meeting you and working with you. Thank you all, and good luck on the rest of your eighth grade year.